So at Scripts and Scribes, we are at Free Comic Book Day, hosted by The Comic Bug. And we are lucky enough to get to speak with Dave Wohl, who's with Aspen. And, okay, so you've created or co-created some great comics. What are some of your favorites?
Well, I think, especially since Aspen is sort of Michael Turner's company, and sort of, it is Michael Turner's company, and his kind of big break was Witchblade, which was sort of my big break as a writer. So I always have a soft spot in my heart for that, even though I worked on it 20 years ago at this point, maybe a little less. Probably the first story arc of Witchblade. Usually whenever I get to collaborate with artists and do what they like to do, it's that's the most fun for me. So Aphrodite 9 was really fun, and Witchblade. And Executive Assistant Iris that I did with Aspen. And again, Eduardo Francisco was the artist on that. And whenever an artist is excited about what they do, I think they do better work.
It's probably nice to have that collaboration between the artist and the writer, you know, because then you can create a more, fuller
Yeah, you may not always agree with them. I used to be pissed off at night and punch the wall and be all angry. But then I remember one time Mike, I was all upset that, like, I made it, Witchblade was in New York City, but he drew something that was obviously not New York City. I mean, there were, like, palm trees and little slotted, like, windows at the police station. And I'm like, people are going to see this, and they're going to be all upset. And not one person made a comment on it. And that was, like, when I realized that I was the moron, and he knew what he was doing, and I just let him take it away and do it.
Yeah, it's definitely a team effort in this process, for sure. What was kind of your break in? You said Witchblade, but what was kind of your break into the comic world? How did you get your start into comic writing?
You know, it's kind of, I know people, I was a high school intern. I went to high school in New York City, Hunter College High School. And in your senior year, they basically offer you different opportunities. And I had three choices. I wanted to actually be a lawyer. And one of the choices was Marvel, and I was like, Marvel seems fun. So I started working at Marvel as an intern, and I ended up staying there for like 6 years. I worked on Marvel Universe, and I ended up being an editor there. So that was sort of my start. So I can't really advise people that should be their route, because first of all, they have to go to Hunter High School.
Yeah, I think
there were other schools in New York fed Marvel. But being an intern, if you're young, is a really good way to get into the business.
Yep.
But you have to work hard. You can't just be upset that, hey, I'm free labor and they're making me do all this stuff. Like, whatever they give you, you just have to do it and be quiet about it. And the more they see that you're diligent, the more they'll want to work with you.
Yeah, be willing to work.
Most people don't make it because they'd rather do something else.
Yeah, I think that's great advice, though, is, you know, be willing to do the work.
Yeah, I mean, and you're going to be frustrated because it's free.
Right.
You're not going to get paid, but you're going to do something that many people can't do.
And eventually, you know, ideally you'll break
something
through,
will pay
you know,
off,
because
yeah.
You'll build that trust from the community.
Yeah, yeah. And then Marvel, because that's the thing, they never, like, once I started, I'd never had a problem with employment. I mean, people fought for me. I had different jobs I could choose. And all I did was do the job that they asked for.
Right.
Which was put a post-it note on pages and Xerox them 10 times. It was really easy. I'm like, how come people can't do this? But
so I guess then that would probably be some advice you would give is, you know, be invested in what you're actually doing.
Right,
and
no matter
the best
how menial
you
think it is.
Yeah.
Buy coffee or, yeah, it's going to seem like garbage. I mean, I know William Morris, I don't know, whoever here, everyone starts in the mailroom.
Yeah,
like the
exactly.
Thing. So, like, it's just something they do. You know, they're always going to start you at the bottom and you got to work your way up.
Yeah.
Most people, if they start too high, they don't make it because they're not invested like someone who's there from the beginning.
And so you got your start that way, but how did you start actually writing?
So I worked at Marvel for 6 years. And toward the end of my Marvel career, we had like backups and annuals and stuff. So I wrote like little stories. Once we had like a whole bunch of pinups that we never were using. And my boss, Howard Mackey, was like, why don't you write a story around this? Like villains in a bar talking about, oh, when I fought Iron Man, this stuff happened. So I wrote that. But then once Mark Silvestri at Top Cow hired me when it was only a very small company. And he really gave me the opportunity to write because he knew that's what I wanted to do. And the two of us just came up with concepts. And then he said, all right, well, write whatever you want. You know, I'll support you. And so that's where I took off from. So again, it's hard to tell someone else, you know, work with the right person who will let you do that.
But it's because, you know, you built that trust.
Yeah.
And you did your job well.
And I think that in this world, the stuff that Mark and I did when we were at Top Cow, anyone can do. Because there's plenty of ways to publish yourself. And the key is to getting out there. It doesn't matter if no one sees it. Just know that it's out there and you did it. Mm-hmm. You just got to get your work going. And then the more you do, the more you will keep going.
Yeah.
And then once it's out there, then you just say to someone, hey, check out my website. You know, check out the stuff.
And there's so many outlets now.
Yeah.
So it's you just get it out there.
People like who've written stuff 5 years ago suddenly takes off, and then suddenly they're Twilight.
Yeah.
Frank's favorite book.
Perfect. Thank you very, very much for your time
Thank you very much.
Advice and insight. And we are with Scripps and Scribes.
Thank you very much.